I think what's interesting with the play is from the outset, she decides not to be the victim. There's maybe a split second at the top of the play where you see a bit of vulnerability, and then she goes straight in for kind of empowerment, and I'm not going to be a victim. But surrounding this are the tweets and the kind of voices, if we call them the bloggers, which are essentially the keyboard warriors of this world. And you only have to look on, like, I find the Daily Mail comment section, like, such a terrifying place where you read the stuff and you're like, why, who are you to say that? And why are you commenting on that? Like, you're a 50-year-old man, or, you know, a 12-year-old girl. Like, be quiet. And but that equally is a world, and the kind of, what's the word? I guess kind of the internet age of anything you put out there now, that's fact. There's nothing we can really do about that. That's fact. Anybody can comment on anything. Everybody's kind of a reporter or a witness to some extent because of it. And that's really scary. But equally, with kind of photos and explicit things, like, you know, I wouldn't send one, definitely, because like, I've seen, you see what happens and it's lessons learned, but people do, and you trust people, and that trust gets broken and the photos end up where they end up. And it's just, it's, I think it's scary. There's not really anything that can be done about it. It's a really hard kind of thing to navigate when you're in that situation. From what we've been looking at in rehearsals, the research we did, kind of there's not a huge amount the police can do. And it's up to each website if they take it down or not. And that's really scary. But that's the iPhone generation, I think.